This video will guide you through the 200-hour Debonair Plus air spring service for single crown RockShox suspension forks. View a list of parts, tools, and supplies in the video description below. Follow the link in the video description below or click the link in the upper right corner for instructions on how to remove the lower leg prior to the Debonair Plus spring service. Verify all pressure is removed from the fork and the air spring shaft is fully extended before proceeding. Failure to do so can result in injury and/or damage to the fork. Refer to the lower leg removal video or service manual for more information. Remove the air spring top cap. Press down firmly when loosening the top cap. The fork top caps are tightened to a high torque value. Ensure the fork is held securely in the bicycle stand. To avoid damage to the top cap, press the top cap cassette tool squarely and firmly down when loosening. Use a socket wrench with a long handle for extra leverage. Clean the upper tube threads. Remove the top cap O-ring and discard it. Apply grease to a new O-ring and install it. Install a section of protective split plastic tube or a shop towel around the air spring shaft to protect the shaft surface during removal. Do not scratch the air spring shaft. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. Remove the retaining ring. Remove the split plastic tube or shop towel from the shaft. For air springs without buttercups installed, thread a bottom bolt onto the shaft for added grip. Push the shaft halfway up into the upper tube, then quickly and firmly pull the shaft out to dislodge the seal head. Remove the air spring assembly and seal head spacer from the upper tube. Do not scratch the inside of the upper tube. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the crown steerer upper tube assembly if a scratch is visible. Clean the inside and outside of the upper tube. Inspect the inside and outside of the upper tube for damage. Scratches on the inside surface of the upper tube can cause air to leak. Replace the crown steerer upper tube assembly if a scratch is visible. If buttercups are not installed, proceed to the next step, air spring service. Clamp the lower buttercups housing into a vise with the reverb vise blocks on the wrench flats, with the air spring oriented upward. Hold the air spring shaft for support and unthread the upper buttercups housing from the lower buttercups housing. Remove the air spring assembly from the lower buttercups housing and set it aside. Remove the buttercups bumper from the lower buttercups housing and discard it. Remove the lower buttercups housing from the vise. Clean the lower buttercups housing. Clamp the air spring shaft 12 to 15 millimeters below the end of the shaft into the 10 millimeter slot of the reverb vise blocks or RockShox rear shock vise block with the air piston oriented downward. Clamp the air spring shaft only tight enough so it does not spin when the buttercup shaft end plate is removed. Do not scratch the air spring shaft. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. Do not clamp the shaft in the middle. Clamping force will damage the air spring shaft. If the shaft is damaged, the air spring assembly must be replaced. Unthread and remove the buttercup shaft end plate from the air spring shaft. Remove the buttercup shaft end plate O-ring and discard it. The small O-ring does not need to be removed or replaced. Remove the air spring shaft from the vise and vise blocks. Remove the upper buttercups housing and bushing assembly from the air spring shaft and set it aside. For travel change procedures, follow the link in the upper right corner or in the video description. Remove the air seal head assembly and top out bumper from the air spring shaft. Discard the seal head assembly. Clean the top out bumper. Clean and inspect the air spring shaft for damage. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. Remove the glide ring, quad ring, and backup ring from the air piston and discard them. Do not scratch the air piston. Scratches will cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. Clean the air piston. Install a new backup ring onto the air piston. Apply grease to the new quad ring seal and install it onto the air piston above the backup ring. Install a new glide ring tapered end upward above the quad ring seal. apply a liberal amount of grease to the air spring shaft. Apply a thin layer of grease to the new top-out bumper and install it onto the air spring shaft. Apply grease to the inner and outer seals on the new seal head. Install the new seal head assembly onto the air shaft, flat side first. Remove the grease from the inner shaft threads. If buttercups are not being installed, proceed to the next step, air spring installation. Install the buttercup's upper housing and bushing assembly onto the air spring shaft. Apply grease to a new O-ring and install it onto the buttercup shaft end plate, over the threads. Clean all grease from the threads. Apply Loctite Thread Locker 2760 Red or equivalent to the first 2 to 3 full threads of the buttercup's shaft end plate. Position the upper buttercup's housing above the vise blocks. Clamp the air shaft into the 10mm slot of the Reverb vise blocks or RockShox rear shock vise blocks. Clamp the air shaft only tight enough so it does not spin when the buttercups is tightened. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. Thread the buttercup shaft end plate into the air shaft and tighten it. Apply Loctite Thread Locker Blue 242 or equivalent to 3 full outer threads on the lower buttercup's housing. Install a new buttercup's bumper into the lower buttercup's housing, wide end first. Position the lower buttercup's housing and bumper onto the buttercup's end plate. Slide the upper buttercup's housing and bushing assembly up and thread it onto the lower buttercup's housing finger tight. Remove the air shaft from the vise and vise blocks. Clamp the lower buttercup's housing into a vise with Reverb's vise blocks on the wrench flats. Air spring piston oriented upward. Tighten the upper buttercup's housing onto the lower housing. Apply a liberal amount of grease evenly around the end of a clean plastic dowel, approximately 150 millimeters from one end. Use the dowel to apply grease to the inside surface of the upper tube, approximately 150 millimeters into the tube. Apply grease to the air piston and seal head outer O-rings. If installing a new air spring shaft, apply grease above and below the seal head. Slide the seal head and top-out bumper up and down to spread the grease and lubricate the seals. With the crown steerer upper tube assembly clamped in the bicycle workstand, orient the upper tubes upward and the steerer tube oriented downward. Insert the air spring assembly into the upper tube. Firmly push the air piston into the upper tube. Inject 1 milliliter of Maxima Plush Dynamic Suspension Lube Heavy into the upper tube, between the piston and seal head, in the negative chamber. Insert the air seal head into the upper tube and firmly press it into the upper tube until it stops. Remove the O-ring from the spring spacer and discard it. Apply grease to a new seal head spacer O-ring and install it onto the seal head spacer. If installing a new seal head spacer and O-ring, apply grease to the O-ring on the seal head spacer. Insert the seal head spacer into the upper tube, O-ring end first, and seat it into the upper tube step until it stops. Install a section of protective split plastic tube or a shop towel around the air spring shaft to protect the shaft surface during installation. Do not scratch the air spring shaft. Scratches can cause air to leak. Replace the air spring assembly if a scratch is visible. For Zeb forks, eyelet retaining rings have a sharper edge side and a rounder edge side. Installing retaining rings with the sharper edge side facing the tool will allow for easier installation and removal. Place the tips of the retaining ring pliers into the eyelets of the retaining ring. Then use the pliers to push the seal head into the upper tube while installing the retaining ring into the groove. Confirm the retaining ring is properly seated in the retaining ring groove by using the retaining ring pliers to rotate the retaining ring and seal head back and forth a few times. Lyric and Pike uses a different style retaining ring. For Lyric and Pike forks, lift both prong ends from the center of the ring to open up the retaining ring for installation. Insert the inner retaining ring prong end into the upper tube retaining ring groove. Using your finger, guide and push the retaining ring edge, starting at the installed prong end, around the upper tube edge and into the groove. The retaining ring is installed completely when the outer prong end snaps into the groove. Confirm the retaining ring is properly seated completely in the retaining ring groove. Remove the split plastic tube or shop towel from the shaft. Inject or pour Maxima Plush Dynamic Suspension Lube Heavy into the air spring upper tube. Install the air spring top cap into the upper tube and tighten it. Press down firmly when tightening the top cap. Follow the link in the video description or click the link in the upper right corner for instructions on how to install the lower leg on your RockShox suspension fork.